The Odyssey. The foundational work of Western literature was composed by an unknown author in an age of partial or total illiteracy. The Odyssey, together with the Iliad, is the earliest narrative of the classical canon. Probably composed around the 8th century BCE, the poem is attributed to Homer, in Greek, the blind man. Homer's birth is claimed by the Greek cities of Smyrna, Rhodes, Colophon, Chios, Argos, and Athens. His fame among later Greek poets developed into a cult of personality. On the island of Chios, for instance, a guild of professional reciters called themselves the Homeridae, or descendants of Homer. Homer's poems were meant to be recited in a hall and not read by individuals. Their orality led scholars to endless arguments about their composition. Some maintain that Homer is a label given to several generations of oral poets. Some claim that he never existed. Some argue that he did compose both poems attributed to his name. The Odyssey tells the story of the homecoming of Odysseus, a Greek king who fought in the Trojan War and wandered the sea for 10 years seeking his native land. The narrative begins in Odysseus's household on the 20th year of his absence. There, a gang of unruly suitors court his wife, Queen Penelope, while Odysseus is believed to be dead. Compelled by the goddess Athena, Odysseus's son Telemachus sets sail, seeking information about his father's destiny. Odysseus, meanwhile, is held captive on Calypso's island. The nymph, persuaded by the god Hermes, eventually released him. As a tremendous shipwreck tosses Odysseus ashore, he's found by Nausicaa, princess of the Phaeacians, and welcomed in her father's palace. There, he starts narrating his wanderings, how he and his comrades visited the lethargic lotus eaters with their memory-erasing drug, how he was captured by the giant one-eyed cyclops Polyphemus, whom his men blinded with a wooden stake, how the goddess Circe turned his men into swine and led Odysseus into the world of the dead, how they skirted the land of the Sirens, passed between the many-headed monster Scylla and the whirlpool Charybdis, how Poseidon's shipwreck drowned them all but Odysseus, who was washed ashore on Calypso's island, bringing the story back to the start of Odysseus's account. Deeply moved by his story, the Phaeacians deliver him on his home island of Ithaca. Disguised as a beggar, he meets his son Telemachus and they agree to put an end to the suitors' abuses. With Athena's help, an archery competition is arranged to win Penelope's hand. Odysseus easily wins, and upon revealing his identity, he slaughters all the suitors as peace is restored on his kingdom. The Odyssey is able to illustrate the entirety of Greek culture, a feat that would be unimaginable in our time. Scholar Eric Havelock defined it a tribal encyclopedia, a narrative that encompasses every aspect of its culture, from how to gear a warrior's armor to the rules of civilized hospitality. The poem's hero, too, embodies the values of his era. Odysseus is Polymedus, the man of many counsels. He wields his cunning to outsmart his enemies and overcomes challenges through his ingenuity. The sophisticated structure of the Odyssey has had enormous influence on the art of storytelling. As William Kerr wrote, "The labor and meditation of all the world has not discovered, for the purpose of narrative, any essential modification of the procedure of Homer." Nothing is known about the composer of this work of genius. In the craft of storytelling, however, there has yet to come an author who will overcome this unknown master.